Hey guys, I'm Risha.
Hey guys, I'm Ibrahima.
Hey guys, I'm Risha.
I'm Ibrahima.
And we're the Mandinka Family. And today we're going to have what's it called? Intimate questions to spark conversations with your partner. So we're going to be answering some questions to each other. So stay tuned, you guys.
Stay tuned, guys.
You be my queen, you be my skin saver. I be a king, no be cinema. Diamond, mineral, situation critical. You be my queen, you be my skin saver. I be a king, no be cinema. Diamond, mineral, situation critical. Sun kiss your body, glitter, glitter.
All right, guys. So as we mentioned, we are going to
ask questions that will spark conversation, so check it out, guys.
All right, so we're gonna just take turns, okay? We'll just choose whatever question you get, you just have to answer it, and vice versa.
That's right.
All right, you have the first one.
Ladies first, baby. Always.
Okay, so what makes our relationship unique?
Well, what makes our relationship unique is, you know, like, you know, we are both understanding, you know, we compromise, you know, things for each other, you know, like, that's something that I would say, you know, is really unique about us.
Okay.
Yeah. What do I do that annoys you? Can you tell me that?
There's a lot of things you do that annoy me. He loves, like, I wish you guys could see some of the bloopers, because when we're recording, he'll want to put his finger in my ear, he'll want to, like, lick my face and, like, be silly. He does a lot of things, but, yeah, he'll just want to get in my ass whenever he wants to, like.
But I can't fit in your ass,
though. But, you know, guys, he's just, sometimes he's silly, like, when I don't want him to be. What else he do that annoys me? He has a bad habit of, like, putting food on the floor. That annoys me. Mm. But I'm pretty sure I do things that annoy you,
of
too.
Of course, yeah.
All right, so let's move on. All right.
You know, he doesn't want me to say the parts that annoy me, but okay.
All right, guys, so here's the next question. What's your favorite imperfect thing you like about me? Like, for example, like, I like the bunions on your toes.
What?
Your bunions.
What's that? Like these muscles?
The bunions.
What's that?
The bunions.
I don't know what the bunions are.
So, like, something that's not necessarily perfect about me, but you like it. It could be, like, the fact that I don't have good, I don't have healthy eyes, like, so I have to wear glasses. It could be anything that's imperfect about me.
Something that is not like, each shot is not about perfect or imperfect. So, if I would say, I would just say, you've been shorty, but yeah, that's what I would say.
Okay.
All right.
Your turn.
Why did you marry me?
Why did I marry you? Mm. I married you because I love how you took care of your parents, specifically more so your mom. You know, guys, before I married him, when we were just, you know, talking or dating, his mom at one point in time was, actually, before we even were, like, boyfriend and girlfriend or dating, we were just considered, like, friends, and his mom was sick, and, like, when I used to talk to him every day, I would just be like, hey, what are you doing today? What are you up to? And he would be like, I'm going to go see my mom. Like, every day he would mention his mom. He was like, oh, I gotta go see my mom, she's sick, I gotta go check on her, I gotta go take care of her, I gotta bring her this medicine, stuff like that. And it was like a consistent thing. It wasn't just something like, you know, that he just did on an inconsistent basis. He was always there trying to take care of his mom. And not just that, like, just his family as well. But when I looked at him, I was like, damn, I was like, you know, he would make a great husband and a great father, because he really, you know, loves to take care of the people that he loved. And, you know, in America, there's a saying, like, if he, how he treats his mother is how he can treat you. So I really believe deeply in that. So that's one of the main reasons I did marry him. All right, so my turn, guys. What do you fear about this relationship?
What I fear about this relationship, the, I would say, the distance. You know, like, you all know, long distance relationships are so easy. You know, like, you know, people might be saying stuff, and also, like, you know, sometimes, you know, like, the mental can. People can be problems, you know, you might call your spouse and, you know, him, you wouldn't get to, like, you, they might not, you know, see your call in time, or your call might appear as missed call, you know, stuff like that, and then you might be in that, like, what is he or she doing, stuff like that. Even my wife, sometimes, like, if I call her, she wouldn't be able to pick my call, and I'm saying, like, that sometimes can be, you know, I'm saying, like, something that, you know, one can look into, you know, very seriously. You have to be compromising, you know, to be able to accept, like, you know, take those things. Yeah.
Okay. Yes, sir.
What is something you are hesitant to tell me?
What is something you're hesitant to tell me? I feel like we're open, like, we're pretty much open, like, there's nothing that, like, I can't tell you, you know what I mean? I'm just trying to think, like, what is something I would be hesitant to tell you, you know? You already kind of know my beliefs and stance on everything. Maybe I'm lazy. That's not something people want to admit. I'm lazy. You know, but you can kind of gather that. When I'm at home, I just be chilling all day. So sometimes I can be lazy. All right, my turn, guys. Describe how you felt when you met me for the first time at the airport.
I felt like I'm in heaven. When I saw her walking, like, she didn't really, recognize or see me, like, but for me, when I saw her, like, walking down with her shorty self, I'm like, that's my bear right there. So I woke up to her, like, I felt like I'm in heaven for real. Like, you know, the moment I, you know, like, hugged her, and then I went deep straight, I kissed her, and then, like, I'm like, I'll be getting happy.
Oh, snap.
All right.
So my turn.
Okay, guys. When do you feel closest to me?
When do I feel closest to you? I feel closest to you when we are having a deep conversation with each other. Like, that, sometimes when he's very serious, he'll be like, Risha, you know, I really love you. And, like, he'll give me that eye contact without breaking your eye contact. Whenever you're sitting and you're, like, looking me in the eyes and you're really, like, serious about what you're saying, I can, like, connect with you on that level. That, I feel like that's one of the times that I feel really closest to you.
And, guys, last
and final question.
You want to check it out?
How does our different religious beliefs affect our relationship?
How does our religious beliefs affect our you know, like, you know, I'm speaking of, you know, like, you know, honesty or what's really might be on me and my babe, we talk about, you know, our religious differences and, you know, our beliefs, you know, like from the very beginning, and we, you know, I would say, she definitely been bringing it, here and there, most times, for us to talk about, we revisit our conversation that we have about, because these are key, important things, when it comes to, two people that come together that are of different, religious backgrounds, but I believe, we do understand, each other in many things, because we for many times, I would say in a month, we would, within 1 or 2 months, and we would definitely revisit this, conversation, and, try to make each other, understand, and to have a brief conversation about it, and also understand each other in it, yeah. So, I would say, religious, beliefs would definitely affect our religion, our marriage, because we, visit our stuff and talk about it. Like, for example, if we have a child, what do you think the child would be? Like, of course, my wife will go and have our child to be, what she believes in, and I will go and my child to be what we believe in. And that people might think, oh, that's going to be a problem. No, it's not going to be a problem. We have an agreement about that, okay, whatever our child wants to be, when they grow up, that's what they're going to be.
Right.
So, I think, that's the most, that would be the thing that, we might say, oh, no, that would be an issue. But, yeah.
All right, guys. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. As far as that last question, we will be touching base on that topic. There's a whole video for that topic of our different religious beliefs. But if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. What's our social media?
Mandinka Family on Facebook, Mandinka Family on IG.
All right, guys, until next time, we will see you. And don't forget, black love is black power. See you guys.